Universal began their expansion of adding a second theme park in 1995. They wanted a park that would appeal to families with younger children, with each section of the park being a themed island to explore. After announcing Islands of Adventure as their next park and changing the property name to Universal Studios Escape, planning began on Seuss Landing. The designing and planning for the land took over a year. Audrey Geisel, Dr. Seuss's late wife, gave her approval and go-ahead after reviewing these plans. The first thing to be built in all of Islands of Adventure was the Zax Bypass. A north-going Zax and south-going Zax are refusing to go in different directions, which makes it impossible to solve their issue. Years passed by and the city grew around them in their story. Inspired by children's author Theodore Seuss Geisel, aka Dr. Seuss, this land was designed with little ones in mind. Signs are low to the ground, steps are smaller and shorter, and there are several play areas for younger children to enjoy. Dr. Seuss himself even makes an appearance in the land. When constructing this land, the creative team did not want any straight lines in the park. Even the palm trees are bent and twisted, which were left over from Hurricane Andrew that hit South Florida in 1992. The tall, curvy buildings were made from styrofoam to keep up with the no straight lines rule. Seuss Landing has four attractions for families to enjoy. One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish has riders trying to avoid spitting fish while flying up and down. This attraction is inspired by the book of the same name, just like its neighbor. The Cat in the Hat was the book that made Seuss famous, and the ride is one of the most popular in the park as well. Added in 2007, the High in the Sky Seuss Trolley Train Ride takes guests on a bird's eye view tour of the land, with excellent views of the park as well. The carousel is unique in that each character can move when prompted.
The number one attraction at Seuss Landing is the carousel.
One of the most unique merry-go-rounds ever built. Every animal on the carousel is interactive. Kids can pull on the reins and the animals animate for them.
Assembled in a secret warehouse hundreds of miles from Universal Orlando, the carousel was the most difficult and complex ride conceived for Seuss Landing. Designers spent years and millions of dollars to create storybook creatures fitted with specially designed control levers. So, when a child pulls on the reins of a character, their head moves, their nose twitches, or their eyes wink.
There are four different places to grab a bite at, including Circus McGurkus, Cafe Stupendous, and Green Eggs and Ham Cafe, which is shaped like a green ham on a dinner plate. In December of 2000, Grinchmas began to celebrate the holidays at the parks. During Grinchmas, you were able to meet the Grinch himself and other Whos around the land, see a play of How the Grinch Stole Christmas, and admire holiday decor around the land. In 2002, Halloween Horror Nights came to Islands of Adventure. Mrs. Geisel did not want anything scary in the land, so the scare zone of Booville was formed. The Whos were scared of the Grinch, so they stayed in their homes, giving an abandoned feeling to the scare zone. No scare actors would appear in the land, only fog and creepy music. In 2003, the Booville zone reportedly had the Grinch lurking in the shadows to follow the story of this scare zone. And that's the history behind Seuss Landing at Islands of Adventure. Leave a comment down below on your favorite parts of this land or park. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.